It's my birthday today. I'm 29 years old. How mental is that? Thank you to everyone who's already messaged me today. Same schedule as always. Video at 7 p.m. Another one at 9 p.m. over on Facebook. But also, I think I'm going to go ahead and stream tonight. Maybe we'll do like a birthday celebration stream. If so, you'll see it after this video. We'll do it kind of like 8 o'clock, I guess. Something like that. But yeah, I can't believe I'm 29. I can't believe that I started this channel when I was 18, 19 years old. And here I am at 29. I'm almost 30. Anyway, I'm getting sidetracked. Basically, I'm getting old. And here I am still obsessed with career mode and making videos on YouTube and stuff like that. But anyway, as you know, we're in the transfer window. And I want to make some pretty serious changes to the team. You know, if this is the final season, which I think it will be, it's just a 2-season series. I kind of want to go out with a bang, if that makes sense. I want to make some pretty big changes to the team. So let me go ahead and shortlist the players that I want to sell. There might be some that you guys disagree with, and that's absolutely fine. And by the way, I know Smalling won't ever sell because he's retiring, so we'll just take him off the list. There's a few players that have been good in some areas or some situations, and they've also been pretty bad. There's some players that you probably think I'm going to sell, but actually I'm not going to. Chetin, for example, might have had a few bad experiences so far with him, but I'm going to keep him just because I need centre-backs. Actually, I do have quite a few, don't I? Maybe I don't need Chetin. The problem is I play with 3 centre-backs, so having 7 is probably a good idea. It's 3 for the first team, 3 for the second team, and then a spare one. So we'll leave that as it is. The first player I'm looking to move on is actually Veretu. I know you're probably thinking, what? He's 82 rated. But the thing is, I actually don't use him that much. And apparently he's potentially going to be leaving in real life. So that would happen in the summer. They didn't do it in the January transfer window. Another player I'm looking to potentially move on is Ihattaren. It just doesn't work. I like to play him in that cam role, which Zaniolo, even someone like Under, Mkhitaryan, they kind of occupy that role. The whole idea with Ihattaren was to play him as a centre mid, but I can't retrain him. Is it me or is my chair getting lower? I feel like my chair just sunk. Maybe it's just me. I'm going to go ahead. Oh, I can't sell him. Damn. Okay. Well, Ihattaren is staying, so maybe that's a sign that I should let Mkhitaryan go instead. Maybe I sell Diawara. I don't know now. It's kind of made me change my mind a little bit. Let's see if I can convert. Oh, I am. I'm converting Talisca to a striker 2 weeks away. He is a centre forward, so it doesn't really matter too much. Okay, maybe I change my stance here. Maybe I sell Diawara instead. I literally don't use him. I only need 2 centre mids in my first team, so I'm getting lower again. Yeah, look, I have. Wait. Is that better? I definitely sunk. There's something wrong with my chair, clearly. I don't really use too many centre mids, so I'm going to sell, you know, 3 of them, potentially, including Mkhitaryan, and bring 1 baller in, so I think that's probably my plan. Let's have a look at my shortlist and I'll show you who I'm looking at. So Arthur from Juventus. You're probably wondering why they're all from my league in the Serie A. Well, why do you think? I want to weaken one of my rivals. So Arthur, Elmas, big fan of this guy. North Macedonian as well. Not your typical country that you see transfers from. He's a really good player. Milinkovic-Savic. I mean, it's a bit much, seeing as they are our rivals, but I thought I'd have a look at his stats anyway. He is just ridiculous, but nah, it's not going to happen. I just kind of wanted to, as I said, take a look at him. So we'll remove Milinkovic-Savic. We've also got Rabiot that I'm actually very interested in because I do kind of want a left-footed centre mid. And he is unreal in this game. He really is. So there's 3 choices right there. 46 million to sign Rabiot. Arsenal had an offer rejected, so he's clearly a wanted man. Could I get Rabiot in? He would play ahead of Oliveira, and Oliveira would then go on the bench. I think it could work quite well. I'm scouting Arthur and Elmas, but I don't know if I'm going to want them more than I want Rabiot. I like Rabiot. I think he could be perfect. So we'll go ahead and advance here into the game against Fiorentina, which, of course, we need to win as well. We are doing okay. We had a few recent mishaps. We definitely dropped a lot of points where I shouldn't have. So that has definitely affected our points at the moment. But you know what? We're third place with an extra game in hand here. If I win it, I stay 1 point behind Inter. So Fiorentina down in 12th, clearly missing Vlahovic. I think they sold him. We'll see. They're not doing very well this season, so I anticipate a win here. Oh dear, it's snowing. I didn't notice. That's my bad. That could make things tricky. And it's a white ball, white lines. Oh man, that's a problem. That is a big problem. Okay, it's not as bad as it is on PlayStation. The next-gen experience with the snow is awful. They have Vlahovic. He's given me the ball straight away there. How are they below mid-table with Vlahovic up top? That actually makes no sense. How is that possible? Oh, my God, and the ball's gone out. I hate playing in the snow with an absolute passion. Oh, okay. I've lost the ball in a bad area there. Try and shut them down. Nice. Try again. Nice. Try again. How many attempts do I need to make to actually keep the ball? This is ridiculous. Vlahovic inside to Polgar, and they've lost it again. Yeah, this is not fun. I think what it is for me is I play with quite a high contrast on my monitor, and the snow is blinding. I mean, I could just change the contrast for this game, but it's annoying. I don't want to have to do that. Spinazzola loses it. Can we get it back? Nice, Oliveira. Oh, no. They're going to hit me on the counter here. It's a nice through ball. Here's Chiesa. Of course, he's on loan at Juventus in real life, so he's gone back after the first season here. And he's going back to that right-back position. What was he thinking? Here's Pellegrini. You know what I'm going to do here. Bang! Go on. Oh. Did he get a touch? No. So the shot went wide. But for a split second, come on, admit it. You thought that went in as well. Or at least you thought it was closer than that. Go on, Zaniolo. What a pass that is. He's going to get it. Hello? Oh my God. The snow is clearly blinding the referee as well. How is that not a free kick and potentially a red card? Unreal. Absolutely unreal. Put it through. Oh, it's a bad pass. I'm fuming, mate. Absolutely fuming. That's a good turn from Talisca. He's in. So easy. And what a save by Dragowski. Fair enough. I actually expected a goal there. Corner coming in from Pellegrini. That's a good ball. No, it's not. It's bad. It's going to come all the way out here to Ibanez. Edge of the box. And it's gone. Okay, this has been a relatively poor first half. Oh, hang on. It's not over yet. Zaniolo saved by Dragowski again. Okay, last opportunity before the break. Delivery coming in. Not bad. Klojek's there. Here's Ibanez again. Yeah, we don't need to talk about that. I wish that went in. I wish that went in. I'm still waiting to score a long-range effort with Oliveira. I've scored so many with Pellegrini, it's just not landing in that top corner for Oliveira, who, let's face it, probably has better shooting. So it's a bit of a weird one. That's unreal. Oh, my God. I don't deserve to be losing this. This is unreal. It really is. I can't believe we're losing. Okay. That's fine. It's not fine, but that's fine. I'm not going to be angry. We have 35 minutes left. We need two goals. That's nice. Come on, mate, the Niles. Oh, no. So annoying when that happens. Oh, he's got it back. And he scores! Maitland-Niles. It's not the first time I've scored a goal like that, where I think it's over and then I win a last second tackle. What a finish from Maitland-Niles, honestly. I don't think Karsdorp scores there. I really don't. In this position here, I think Karsdorp misses. But Maitland-Niles, who can easily play as a centre mid, he's got better quality assets in that area. He's able to finish it. Right, come on, we need one more. I think my chair just moved down again. I mean, I could be going insane. It might be my old age. Oh. What can I say? Who is that? It's Miranchuk? Is it? I mean, it's truly world class. In just the last few episodes, I could put together one of the best montages of career mode goals you would ever see. I mean, that is top quality from Miranchuk. Okay. I haven't made any changes yet. I think it might be time. Next time the ball goes out, I will definitely be bringing on, I think, Tammy. Tammy on for Talisca, maybe. Come on, we need one back here. Come on. Oh, no. Running out of space. Zaniolo. Back post. Go on. Oh, he's just about got there. And I've lost it. It's not looking good, is it, guys? Good tackle. Come on. Yes. Ah, I've overrun it again. No. Game over. Oh, he's hit the bar. Probably still not going to win this. Not enough time. The ball hasn't even gone out. I haven't been able to get any subs on. Here goes Pellegrini. He is quick. Talisca. Oh, that was close. Plojek. No. Bad first touch. I don't know why I ran straight into him, to be honest. Okay, well, technically, the goal I scored in this game was gifted to me, so this has just been, overall, a very bad result. One last attempt here. Nope, the referee's had enough. Oh, we've lost again. Every time I think I'm getting back in there, I'm catching the top teams. I then make a mistake and lose another game. Well, we've got some transfer offers by the looks of it. Oh, okay, just one. And it is Norwich asking for Diawara, asking to purchase him for his value. 8.5 million euros. Do you know what? I'm going to accept it. As I said before, I'm just not using him. Let's see. Smalling. You're valuable. Veretout. I'm looking at options, which is true. I still might keep hold of him. Diego Carlos is 84. Yep, look at that. So good. Really happy with him as a signing. I'll just put him on stopper. Okay, right. We need that money in. We get an offer for Veretout. Sassuolo. 14 million. I mean, is that all I'm going to get for him? Because if that's the case, I don't actually think it's worth selling him. So who are my benched DMs and centre mids at the moment? Let's have a look, shall we? So it's Veretout and Ihattaren. Okay. It would become Oliveira and Ihattaren. And then if Veretout's not there and Diawara's not there, it just leaves Busio and Cristante, who, by the way, is actually a very good player. I quite like him. So I think it's doable. And with the money we get for Veretout, it's probably enough to get Rabiot. And he is ultimately the target I'm looking for, I think. So I'm actually going to accept this. Sassuolo, 14.5 million. If that goes through, we should have enough. Should have enough. Let's see what happens. We've got Empoli coming up. Oh, Veretout's gone. And so is Diawara. Gone. Just like that. And now we have our scout reports. So is Rabiot the right choice? Remember, this player is going to partner Pellegrini. They need to be a bit more defensive. And from what I can see here, Elmas, he's a good player, but he's not going to be good enough to get into the first team. So I think that is a no. Rabiot's only 81 rated. Really? I'm quite surprised at that. I thought he'd be higher rated. Oh, I don't know who to go for now. 32 million, 22 million, roughly. Okay, that's a lot cheaper than I thought. But even though I'm technically weakening one of my rivals, I think I can do better. I might look around and see if there's someone else from a different league. It doesn't have to be from the Serie A. It was just an idea I had. Okay, well, I've gone through the main leagues and I found quite a few other players that I could look into. Van der Beek, we could save him from Manchester United. I saw Paredes had 6 months remaining on his contract, so we'd be able to get him really cheap, like super cheap. Kondogbia, a player that I've always admired, really good player in FIFA. He's just an absolute tank. And also, Saul seems a bit out of favour at Chelsea. Clearly, Atletico Madrid don't rate him as highly as they used to. And he's left-footed. You know, I am looking for a left-footed player, so Kondogbia also provides that. So I guess we scout. But I'm most interested in Paredes right now. His wages will be high, but I'll get him super cheap and I can probably afford to buy someone else, you know? Up next is Empoli. Let me just check the calendar. We've got a couple of days until a cup game, so we can use the first team for sure. I mean, they're bottom of the league. Surely we win this. Quick sim, please no injuries. We get a 1-0 win. Pellegrini, get in there, son. Let's see if we can get these scout reports done before that cup game. And then try and get this central midfielder signed up. Oh, Mkhitaryan's had an approach. And Boca Juniors are interested. All because of that stupid contract bug. He's got 6 months remaining. Yeah, sure, I'd like to offer him 0 months extension. What's the point of that? Absolutely stupid, isn't it? Oh, okay. For a second, I thought it was an actual transfer offer, but no, it's just talks have broken down. I guess because his wages are astronomical for a club like that. But anyway, we've got scout reports back. Let's see what rating they are. Oh, dear. So Van der Beek is not really an improvement on Rabiot. Neither is Paredes. Kondogbia is lower rated than I thought. And actually, Saul seems to be the best choice by quite far. Maybe I should bring in Saul. I think it's an interesting transfer. He's pretty much what I'm looking for. I'm going to do it. Clearly unwanted at Atletico Madrid. At Chelsea, it hasn't worked out. Why not settle for Roma? Why not? I could try a player swap, but I don't think I need to. Who would I even offer? No goalkeepers, no wingbacks. I mean, Chris Smalling, maybe, or Chetin. Do you know what? I think I'd play Chris Smalling over Chetin, so I might do it, actually. Chetin plus 18, something like that. And they want Mancini plus 8. Yeah, I'm not looking to let Mancini go. Don't want to do a striker. Don't really want to do a winger. Other midfielders. Oh, Mkhitaryan. Oh my God, it's perfect. It's actually perfect. Imagine if I can get this done. So he's worth 12 million. Do you know what? I'm going to give them a really good deal here. 24. Total. Go on, please. They don't want him. The game probably is smart enough to know that he's going out of contract, so there's no real value there. Okay, we're going cash only. 25. Quarter of 100,000. Just take it. 26.1. Whatever. Let's do it. Let's get him in. He's going to be a very, very good signing for us. We're going to revive his career here at Roma. He's on a big wage at the moment, which is a bit of a shame. We'll go important. 3-year contract. Doesn't really matter for me, of course. No need for a release clause, although it seems he really wants one. I'm just going to deny it. Even though it makes no effect on me, really. He's willing to come down quite a lot on his wages. I'm going to remove that bonus. I will go to 95,000 and just bring this down to 650. How about that, Saul? Come on. Done deal. I told you I needed a central midfielder, and I've done it. Easy as that. I'm tempted to get Paredes anyway, because he is such a good player. But it's not really necessary, is it? So Oliveira goes to the bench, and I really like Oliveira, so it's a bit of a shame, but I do feel like he is a bit of a weak link, especially when I'm getting teams pass it through the middle of the pitch. He's just a bit slow. It's a shame because, unfortunately, it is a problem in FIFA if your player is slow. 59 pace compared to 71. It's quite a chunk. So Saul comes in and he will partner up with Pellegrini perfectly. He's in his prime. 28 years old, 83 rated. That is an improvement in the team. As simple as that, really. I can't include Hatterin in any deals, can I? I would have liked to have done a swap. I might try. I might give it a go. I don't remember seeing Hatterin pop up, though. So I don't have anyone here that I really would like other than Paredes. So just to experiment, obviously I can approach to sign him for free, but I can just sign him now. I'm going to approach and see if I can offer Hatterin straight swap. I don't think I can, though. Oh, no, I've tried to approach him for free, haven't I? Sporadic, we need to cancel this. He wants important, end negotiation. We'll have to come back and try that. Negotiations were unsuccessful. Yeah, I was meant to not talk to the player directly. I wanted to just buy him, but it's okay. I don't actually need him. Maybe I'll just keep Hatterin. He's not a bad player to have, is he? I don't use Kluivert much, so I think what I'd end up doing is having Hatterin there. Yeah, see, I still need another centre mid, don't I? I do. That is probably what I need to do. Okay, well, at least I feel like I have a plan now, more so than before. I'm willing to let Chetin go, and I'm willing to let Kluivert go. Maybe. All right, that is going to be the end of today's episode, my birthday episode. As I said, if I stream, it will be after this episode goes up, so make sure you check it out. Obviously, I've got my Facebook content going up, which is FIFA stuff as well, my Sim to Glory. So tons of content for you guys to watch. Check it all out. Leave thumbs ups, likes, and all that stuff. Thumbs ups? You know what I mean. And I'll see you tomorrow for another one.